Hello, in this video, we will learn how to have color in a spectacular firework display while simultaneously making a very unique compound of iron. Warning, this experiment deals with strong oxidants, very high temperatures, fire and toxic fumes. Potassium nitrate, commonly sold as a source of potassium and nitrogen for plants, is also a very common ingredient in pyrotechnics. In this video, I will be using its oxidizing properties to synthesize a compound of iron in the sixth oxidation state. This is potassium nitrate and I have placed it in this dish. This is steel wool. Now I am going to take a spatula and place a roughly equal mass of the potassium nitrate on the steel wool. Potassium nitrate is plastered onto the steel wool to make sure that it's always in contact with it. It is then rolled up and the ignition is using a glowing splint. I'm lighting the wooden splint with a candle. See, now it's glowing orange. Place it inside the mixture. Let the mixture cool back down to room temperature before you proceed. If you notice, the flames were a brilliant purple due to potassium ions. Now, the product that is formed can then be harvested and placed in a vial. The potassium nitrate has reacted with the iron and completely oxidized it to potassium ferrate, which is iron in the plus 6 oxidation state. The potassium nitrate has then been reduced to nitric oxide, which is a colorless gas. Now the product will be taken with the help of a tweezers and placed in a vial. Water is then added to the mixture . The product has a purplish color due to the presence of the ferrite ion, but it has a hard time dissolving in water. The presence of ferrite can still be proven with the help of concentrated hydrochloric acid. So I have a few drops in this pipette. I'll add it and immediately close the vial. As you could see, there was a brisk effervescence of what we will now prove to be chlorine using sodium iodide solution. I have a piece of paper which I am dipping in it and we will introduce it into the chlorine rich atmosphere. As you can see, the tip of the paper has turned brown due to the liberated iodine. This proves the presence of ferrite in the given product. So this is the oxidation of hydrochloric acid. Potassium ferrite reacts with hydrochloric acid, forming potassium chloride, ferric chloride, chlorine and water. The chlorine is confirmed using sodium iodide solution, and this is a single displacement reaction wherein iodine is liberated, which turns the paper brown. As you can see, the solution is now tinted at very dark yellow due to the formation of ferric chloride. In summary, we saw a brilliant purple flame due to the oxidation of iron, which gave us the product of potassium ferrite. We then proved the presence of this compound of iron using concentrated hydrochloric acid. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video.